Welcome back to part 4, and thanks for watching so far. Brace yourselves, we're starting this video with another top tip.
What are you doing?
I'm taking the stairs instead of the lift for a bit of extra exercise. Although it's down, so it's not that much of extra exercise, but the lifts are very busy, so sometimes it's easy to just take steps.
Good tip, that.
That's enough charity shop Sue impressions, Paul. What I'm actually trying to tell you here is that the place that I'm standing, which is in front of the gym at the front of the ship, is a nice secluded spot with a handful or so of sunbeds that you can see just in the view in the picture there. And this is a very hidden away spot that catches the sun and has not many people, if any, as on this day. So as you can hear in this video, it can get quite windy, particularly on a sea day. However, it's a nice hidden spot and it's well worth checking out. Go to the gym, through the double doors, out to the front.
So we're in the Tuscan Grille, which on a celebrity silhouette is a paid-for restaurant. We paid extra for this, and it's beautiful. It's at the back of the ship on deck 5, beautiful views of the sea. Amazing service. It feels very much more like the Apex class, where there's only a number of about 30 tables or so. And we've just ordered our starter. They come along with lovely bread and freshly chopped basil in oil. And we just ordered our starter. And I've got burrata, tomato and mozzarella. And you've got
crab cake,
and Dad's got soup, and Mum's got nothing, but we'll be having a dessert.
My mum actually enjoyed so much bread that she didn't need a starter. Meanwhile, I had the tuna, and Lee had a very posh carbonara.
How was your dinner? Was it lovely?
It was really delicious, but it was a struggle.
A struggle?
Yeah, you can see it was a real struggle. Yeah, gosh, don't know how you managed.
Don't believe a word of it, because those were his donuts for dessert. Meanwhile, I tucked into a very tasty limoncello cheesecake. We were indeed so stuffed from that really delicious dinner, and we decided to head down to the cabin. When we walked into the room, we noticed the most beautiful sunset, still sea, and it was just absolutely delightful. And it inspired me to play one of my favourite songs by one of my favourite singers, Karen Carpenter. Weary to be home again among the faces of my friends. The day is done. Candles burning by the sea are waiting for me patiently. Not a bad lip sync there, eh? By the time we woke up the next morning, we were already in Skagen, in Denmark, for our last destination.
It always happens on the cruise. I mean, I say always, we've only been on one before, that you find things on the latter couple of days that you wish you'd found earlier. The gift that keeps giving. What we found here on the Celebrity Silhouette is on deck 7, this space that you'll see in a moment called the Hideaway, which is like a little snug sort of little lounge, and they've got a coffee machine there, free coffee, and also these lovely pods to just loll around in. Little tip for you, number 92, is that today is our last shore day. We're in Skagen in the northern tip of Denmark. And as you can see, more people than we expected have actually got off the ship to have a little wander around the village. You'll see in a moment when we pan around. The pool is absolutely gorgeous and empty. There's beds galore, shade, sun, towels. You can get served at the bar over there, just behind the corner here. Nobody waits at the bar, but you've got waiter service on attendance. What we tend to do on these shore days in places that are not particularly exciting and could probably done where you just dock in this town and you can walk in and walk out again, is let everybody get off in the morning, have their wander around, and they all tend to want to come back on for lunch or afternoon tea. We do it the other way around. We stay around the pool, you enjoy the quiet morning, have some lunch, hopefully in the quiet bar, and then going in for the afternoon, because we don't have to be all aboard until 6 p.m. So that way you can get the best of both worlds. Look at that. As an example of what I was just saying, I finally got to sample some of the delights on the Oceanview Cafe buffet menu. It's a little bit of a strange concoction. However, bear with me, I've got jerk chicken, plantain, rice, dal, and salad. But the thing is, you can actually get near to the different stands and you can select, you can choose, you can and ah, instead of having loads of people clamouring around you. And you're getting a Bloody Mary, because, you know, premium drink package, why not? And the space, the tables, it's quiet. Kate Bush is playing, what more could you want?
It's gorgeous in the evening. I'm just going to pan around and show everybody.
Una bella vista. And what a view.
So, tell us about today's stories and news.
News. It is day 11, so tomorrow is the last fall day on the ship.
Mm-hmm.
We're off. First thing in the morning.
Did you just burp on camera?
Yeah. Cut that bit. We're off first thing in the morning the day after tomorrow. So
we've got two more nights and one full day tomorrow.
Tomorrow's a sea day.
So where were we today?
We have been docked in Skagen in Denmark. We did not get off the ship, so we decided to stay on and enjoy the amenities whilst other people were off the ship.
You've been feeling
a little bit under the weather, so tripping my way through it and just chilling. But yeah, we did get COVID last time we went on a cruise, so hopefully it's not that again. Hopefully it's not that. But I'm just trying to keep my distance a little bit from people, and we're actually eating tonight in the Lawn Grille,
which is where we ate on the first night,
which is sort of exposed to the elements. Not many people in there, so.
Hopefully it'll be quiet and we can enjoy it.
Yeah, exactly.
So, peckish?
Relatively peckish. I don't know how I'm peckish. I've eaten so much on this cruise. I'm going to go about 5 kilograms lighter than I started. Lighter, I wish. 5 kilograms heavier than I started with. But that's what an all-inclusive holiday does to you. I suppose it'll have to be good when we get back on dry land.
So, yes, just to pick up where Lee just left off. We are currently sitting in a little area known as the studio, the fine art studio. And actually, I think they do painting in there, but never do the painting there. But this is a lovely little sort of terrace area with 8 rocking chairs and some tables. It's quite sheltered from the elements. Not that it's not a nice evening, it's a beautiful evening. And it's really close to the Mast Grill Bar, Lawn Grille. That's where we're going for dinner tonight. It's gorgeous, actually, and no one's here, so we've got a whole area to ourselves. I imagine if you were here with some friends, this would be a good spot to grab, because not many people know about it. Because at this time, which is 8 o'clock, people are either having their dinner or they're having their pre or post drinks. They're at the pre's or the afters. You know. Most people this time on this ship are already at the afters, because the afters finish at 10 p.m. And it's gorgeous. So yeah, the only thing is there's no bar here. The nearest bar is a sunset bar, which is at the back there, but that's not too far. So come up here, come to the studio.
This is the most expensive white wine I can ever in our drinks package.
Is that why you've chosen it?
It's the Chardonnay...
Elegance.
I don't usually drink Chardonnay, but it's allegedly a nice one. I'll give it a
go. What have I got?
Good old Sauvignon Blanc.
Sauvignon Blanc.
But the sun is beautifully blazing in my face and over the sea over there. They've also put the heat lamps on. So between those heat lamps above my head and that sun, as I said to Lee just then, I feel like I'm living on the surface of Mars. Lovie told me that, it's quite cold. So now I feel like I'm living on the surface of the sun. This can is going to be a combination of heat lamp, Baltic Sea sun, and barbecue sauce.
So we've had our salad starter, we've had our basically a pizza starter.
How many starters do we have in here?
Quite a lot of starters. And now we've got our main steak to come.
Where is it?
We've got a very hot plate here.
Singe your hand.
Not going to touch it, I'll singe my hand.
It's very hot, I can feel the heat. So, between the sun, the heat lamp, and the plates, it's hot.
Yeah. Selling steak.
Steak has arrived.
Cheers, chilling steak. Cheers, chilling steak. Medium rare. Homemade baked beans. Wild rice. Lobster mac and cheese.
Yum, yum.
Look at that sunset behind you. Not even set. It's like really high in the sky.
So quite. Well, it's early. It's only 9 o'clock. It doesn't set. It's all about 11.
Welcome to Scandinavia.
Well, mine's have told them it's our 5-year anniversary.
Well, it is. Yeah,
just about. And bless them, they brought out, without any prompting, a happy anniversary cake pudding.
And what did we say earlier when we came out of the room after showers and there was a little card saying happy anniversary?
Oh, does everyone say that? Does everyone get that? That's not all going to get it. But no, they've...
Oh, lovely celebrity.
Really good. That's, you know, we're not in... Sweet glass with an apple glass, just in common garden veranda. They've still done that, so that's really lovely.
Yeah, bless them. See, still got those touches, haven't they?
Yeah, they're good.
What is it?
A big old slab of sodden sponge and cream, I think.
Mmm.
We've had a lovely moment of our anniversary brought forward by 7 weeks. We won't mention that. Trashed, literally trashed. Trashed, smashed by his cursory buttressing of a wine glass onto the floor. People shouted Mazel Tov. But it's alright. It's what birthday's happened. It's taken away all my thunder. It's the last night on our Celebrity Silhouette 12 Nights cruise around the best of Scandinavia in June 2023. It has been an interesting holiday with some ups and some downs, and we will explain some of those as we go through. But for now, just admire the beautiful view. Can't be beaten as we enter, I think, the English Channel right now. I think over there is Holland, the Netherlands, and over there is the Kent coastline underneath the sun there. It's gorgeous weather. Behind there is the Lawn Grille where we ate last night. Beautiful food, lovely service. This is the lawn where we watched the
Whitney film.
Whitney film a couple of days ago when we were at sea. And there's the beautiful big chair that we've not sat on yet.
Oh, I'm a very small person on a very big chair. Oh, I'm not sure what I'm doing here. But anyway,
so let's give Paul's top three highlights and lowlights. Paul's number one highlight is and has been the weather. We chose the right time of year to go on a Scandinavian cruise, beginning of June. It's been gorgeous weather in the UK while we've been away, but the weather has been perfect for Scandinavia. We've had long days, unbroken sunshine. The only thing was we had a bit of a bumpy grey North Sea day, which we told you about in a previous video. My second highlight has been the food. You cannot fault Celebrity for the quality or the quantity of its food. I dread to think if you were to do a comparison between the video of me now and me on day one. We may do that, maybe we won't because it'll be depressing. You'll see I put on about 4,000 kilograms. My third highlight has definitely been the destinations. The destinations have been perfect. I'm in love with Scandinavia and in particular with Stockholm. Shall we walk a bit and I'll do my lowlights? I'm back. Good job. No, so my disappointment, shall we call it, on this cruise, I should set in context that the disappointments are very much because last year our very first cruise was on Celebrity Beyond, the 10-day Greek Islands and Malta cruise. Gorgeous weather, but also a 1 month old at that point ship. This is a 12-year-old ship which was refurbed in 2020. But we chose to go from Southampton because we wanted no hassle in terms of flights, because we all know that airports these days have become quite stressful spaces, and we were quite lucky because Manchester Airport has been full of delays over the last year or so, and that continues to be a problem. So we selected Scandinavian trip because we went from Southampton. What we hadn't factored in was the fact that inevitably other people in Britain think the same thing, and most of those people tend to be of an older generation. So it has been remarked to by us, by one of our lovely fellow travellers on this ship, who is, by the way, the age of 82, and she's a fabulous woman. She looks about 20 years younger. But she's even remarked that it feels like it's a very, very old crowd on this ship. And in many ways, this has sort of reinforced one of my old stereotypes about cruising, which made me think that I wouldn't do it until I was in my 50s or 60s, that if you go from Southampton, you are more likely to get an older crowd. That's just the nature of people not wanting to fly. And that has had a second knock-on effect, which is to the entertainment. I don't know if it's something to do with cooks, or something to do with the crowd or the vibe, but the entertainment on the Celebrity Silhouette has not been the same as what we had on the Beyond. The entertainment last year on the Beyond, every single night in the theatre, consisted of a sort of West End style ensemble show. And it was a different show every night, all of the 10 nights. They also then did another show in Eden Bar at the back of the ship, which was sort of using similar cast, but a different theme and different music and approach. On this ship, there's been a sort of sparseness of the West End style shows, and there have been a couple of them. One of them was great. We saw one called Life the other night. It was really good. But there's also just, there's been repeats. There's been a single stand-up comedian who's been on two nights. And there's also been a singer who was great, Stephen Barrett, amazing voice, really, really great. But he repeated two nights. And there's, I think, another singer who also was on for two nights. So that hasn't been the variety, and it hasn't been really the standard that we have been able to expect of Celebrity last year. The other thing is that it's felt a little bit end of the pier. It's a little bit hammy, a little bit cheesy, a little bit sort of ooh-ah, Mrs. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. And maybe that's to do with the general demographic that I mentioned before, the Southampton demographic, the average age being in sort of late 70s, that it's not really sort of what we would have expected. And it's not our cup of tea as gay men in our early 40s. And I think the other thing, therefore, has meant that we have felt a bit like outsiders. And this is a little bit of a gay thing. As a gay couple, there are maybe three or four other gay couples on this cruise, but there's been nobody at the LGBTQ drinks hour that we went to at the beginning of the ship, and we therefore haven't really connected with anybody apart from some nice old ladies, which I do love chatting to old ladies, and I am a bit of an old lady myself, aren't I? My final thing, which is a bit of a low light, bit of a disappointment, something that Celebrity could definitely improve, I think this applied actually to the Beyond last year, but was more noticeable on this ship, probably again because of the nature of the passengers, people stayed more on the ship on the shore days, is the speed with which they allow the service. Oceanview Cafe, we've mentioned to you, at peak times is very, very, very busy. It's incredibly busy. It's incredibly frustrating at times because you can't see what's on offer. And there's been quite a lot of times where we've been really struggling to get a table to sit down and have particularly our lunch on a sea day. The other thing is we opted to have the premium drinks package. I'm actually not sure now in hindsight that was a good thing, partly because at different times we both felt a little bit under the weather, and therefore what we realise now we could have done is take the classic drinks package and pay the difference in the price, because the classic drinks package at the moment allows you to have a drink up to $12, not the martinis, and then pay the difference. If you're having a $13 glass of wine, for example, as my dad did, you pay a dollar. So that actually is something that we should have known. But the other thing, and Celebrity, I'm begging you to sort this out, is that the CPass card, which is rubbed off, you can see it's all rubbed off the name. When you hand this in to pay, essentially, for your drinks, the system that they've got takes forever. So they're tapping it for ages, and it creates a huge queue behind you. And this becomes a problem at the pool bar, particularly on busy days, and also in Cafe Albacchio, which is incredibly busy, where they do the coffee to sit in and have also coffee to go away, to take away. That said, I really want to say to you that celebrity staff are gorgeous, lovely, friendly, helpful people. They will do anything for you, and they are really bent over backwards, and they all deserve the tips and the pay rises that they should get, because they work hard on here. So my score for the cruise, this cruise, I have to say, is probably going to be 6.5 out of 10. But I may reflect on that and update it later, depending on what Lee says in his video.
So my highlights and lowlights, I think mine probably not too dissimilar to yours. Highlights, destinations, I think, for me. I mean, that was part of the reason we booked this cruise, but I've never been to any of the Scandinavian Baltic countries that we've been to on this trip. So I think especially Copenhagen and Stockholm were amazing, although Tallinn and Oslo were nice in their own ways too. So really glad to have seen those places, and probably quite like to go back at some point, especially to Copenhagen and Stockholm. I think there seems to be a lot of things there to see that you couldn't really do even in the time we had it. The weather has also been amazing, as you said. It is June, but you don't need necessarily going to think that in Northern Europe the weather is going to be boiling hot and sunny
week before,
all the way through.
It wasn't the week before, right?
It wasn't the week before. I think food, although I've had far too much of it, food and drink has been very nice.
Three letdowns or disappointments?
Low lights. For me, it was probably not celebrity's fault, but this blooming cold or whatever it is that I'm finished the holiday with, it's not been ideal. Considering I had COVID on the last cruise, went on, I feel like it's a bit of a pattern. I'm getting sick every time I go away, but that's not anyone's fault in particular. I think we were a little bit spoiled by going on the Beyond as our first cruise. That was like 6 weeks out of the dock when we went on it last year. It was so amazing and set such a standard, even though the Silhouette is a lovely ship. It had been relatively recently done up and revolutionised, I think it's lovely to call it. I think the space on the Beyond works better with a big central atrium that everything gathers around, and especially in terms of the evening activities and things like that. It's a bit more broken up on the Silhouette. There are at least two atriums. There's the Sky Lounge up on the 14th floor, which is a bit of a cold space, really. Not, hasn't really become the centre of anything. And the crowd, it's not, again, not really celebrity's fault, and possibly just a factor of it being based out of Southampton on this cruise, but has been so much of an older, less diverse crowd than we experienced when we were on the Beyond. In our lives in Manchester, we're constantly surrounded by lots of young and diverse people around where we live, when we go out work, and on this cruise it's been very, very sort of homogenous, middle England, 60s, 70s and up crowd, and I'm sure they're all having a lovely time, but just in terms of comparing it to what we've had on the Beyond, it hasn't sort of set the energy level very high, should we say, especially for the sort of evening activities and entertainments. We haven't really had that sort of party atmosphere that we had on our last trip, and haven't made sort of friends and things like that that have made the trip more interesting like we had last time either.
What did you make of the Pride party? Again, that's actually an illustration where it's not celebrity's fault necessarily.
Yeah, so celebrity did try. There was party on the Saturday.
I think we've got some video of it, maybe we'll put that in here.
Yes. They did their best with it, but there are a few LGBT people on the ship. But perhaps not the critical mass needed to make those sort of events really kind of work. But you know, celebrity did try.
We keep trying, celebrity.
The LGBTQ meetup drinks every night, scheduled in on the calendar, so they're sort of trying to enable it, but obviously if the crowd isn't there, the crowd isn't there. So that was a bit of a shame, really. But I think overall, apart from this cold, it's been a nice holiday. and it probably only suffers in comparison with the Beyond last year, because that was such an amazing experience.
After our reflections on the top deck, we went for our final meal in the Grand Cuvée restaurant. Just a few more calories to top off the fortnight. In the midst of our dinner, we were surprised by the chefs and the waiters all coming out waving their white flags. I mean, their napkins. I think they were surrendering to get rid of us. Apparently, this is a long-held cruise tradition. And then we went to bed.
So, that's it. End of the cruise. It's 8:10. We're in Southampton. First grey sky we've seen since the North Sea. And it's a bit drizzly.
It's boiling. Just started raining the second we've got here. You can see the ship out there. We've got a 4-hour drive ahead of us now. If not more. Yeah. And then we might be off to Salford Pride.
Let's hope so.
Let's see what we can do.
Is your snot feeling better?
No, we're still quite snotty.
Hang on. Good job you topped up the screen wash.
Yes.
Oh, it's back to the mundane joys of daily life.
That's it, holiday over, back to reality. Well, we'll see you later.
Of course, as everybody says, but we do mean it, if you've enjoyed these videos, please do like them and even subscribe to the channel. That way you won't miss out on our forthcoming video, which we're working on. That's going to be a retrospective comparison and review of our two journeys so far on the Celebrity Beyond and the Celebrity Silhouette. Thanks so much for watching and enjoy your cruising.